If you were asked to spot a punk, what would you look for? Dyed hair? Denim vest? Sure, but what about Doc Martens, the durable combat boot? What makes Docs so much more significant than any other work boot? Let's start from the beginning. Doc Martens first came on the scene in 1901 in the form of durable work boots made by the Griggs family in England. It wasn't until 1960 that, after three generations, the Doc Martens we know today came into existence. Since then, the boots have become associated with fashion rather than the working class, and this has a lot to do with the rise of British skinheads in the 60s and 70s. While skinheads today are largely grouped with neo-Nazis, at its roots in the 60s, the skinheads were made up of working class individuals who felt isolated from the hippie movement, hence why they shaved their heads. Around the same time, Jamaican immigrants began to move to the UK and occupied the same poor areas as the skinheads. From this, reggae and ska were introduced to the Brits. It wasn't until the 70s that the far-right movement began to co-opt the skinhead movement by preying on their economic insecurities and making them more sympathetic to their cause. Despite the split among skinheads politically at this time, their fashion did not, and docks were donned universally by all punk subcultures. The boots generally came with black laces, but over time subcultures began to trade them out for differing colors. Though no one really knows how it happened, these colors became associated with different subcultures of the punk community. As of right now, the most common lace colors and their meanings are blue. This is associated with killing a cop. Yellow, often neutral, but others have claimed it to be the color of anti-racist. Purple. In the past, it has been used to represent lovers of ska punk, but more recently, it has become associated with gay pride. However, these meanings are not set in stone. Most of the colored laces have multiple meanings, and these can vary by subculture or region. But there are two colors in particular that are so universally recognized that even hate watch groups have them on their radar. In the Southern Poverty Law Center's Racist Skinhead Glossary, both red and white laces are listed as indicators to spot, well, racist skinheads. White laces are more often associated with white pride specifically, while red laces are geared more towards neo-Nazis, not that there's much of a difference. Of course, all trends pass. These laces were most associated with skinheads, but the look as a whole is falling more and more out of fashion with the far right. The new far right movement has opted for a more clean-cut look, and dress shoes now take priority over combat boots. Maybe one day non-racists can eventually take back the red and white laces they lost long ago, but until that time, maybe it's best to stick with the laces that came with your docks.